Hello students, how are you? So today we are going to begin with the new topic from your English Balbharati textbook. The name of the lesson is lesson number 13, Sultan Ghiyasuddin in the Qazi's court. Now let us start reading. Hundreds of years ago in the eastern province of Bengal, Sultan Ghiyasuddin Azam Shah ruled the land. His capital was Sonargaon. Sultan Ghiyasuddin was a good ruler. He ruled wisely and well. He respected men of learning. He had a deep regard for law. So many years ago, there lived one Sultan. Sultan means king. The name of the king was Ghiyasuddin Azam Shah, and he ruled Bengal. The capital which he ruled was Sonargaon. Now Sultan was a very good ruler. He was very good to his people. He ruled very wisely and in a well manner. He respected men of learning. Men of learning means the people who are very educated and who have lots of knowledge. So he respected the people who have lots of knowledge. And law means rules. So Sultan respected the rules also, because he thought that rules are same for everyone. One day, while the Sultan was practicing with his bow and arrows, he accidentally wounded the only son of a poor widow. So one day this Sultan was doing the practice with his bow and arrow. When he was doing the practice, he by mistakenly shot with his arrow to a boy. And this boy was the only one son of a poor widow. Widow means a lady whose husband has died. That's why she is called as a widow. The wounded boy did not survive. Weeping and wailing, the poor widow went to the Qazi and told him what had happened. So now this little boy, he died. So the lady was crying loudly. Weeping and wailing means crying loudly. So what did the poor widow do? The poor widow, she went to the Qazi and she told what all has happened with her son. Now Qazi is the one who solves the problem of the people. The Qazi was an honest and upright man. He sent an officer to summon the Sultan to his court. When the officer reached the palace, the guard stopped him and inquired about his business. When they learned that he had come to serve a summons on the Sultan, they were shocked. They refused to let him go inside the palace. So now this Qazi, he was a very good person. And whatever work he did, he was very honest towards his work. He always supported the truth. So when he came to know that the Sultan had did this mistake, he sent his officer to summon the Sultan. Now what is the meaning of summon? Summon means to order someone to come. So the Qazi ordered the Sultan to come to the court. So when the officer went to the palace of the Sultan, the guards asked him that why you want to go inside, what is your work to the Sultan. So the officer told that I am here to give summons to the Sultan. Now what is the meaning of summons? Summons means a written notice. In that notice it is written that you have done a mistake, so for this mistake you have to come in the court. A summons is a written notice given to a person who has done any mistake. So the guards, they become very shocked. They said, Oh, what mistake Sultan had did. And they told the officer that no, we are not going to allow you to go inside. Better leave the palace. The officer was now in a fix. The guards did not allow him to enter the palace. But he knew that he could not return without serving the summons. The Qazi would not take him back. He had to find a way of reaching the Sultan somehow. What could he do? He thought and thought. Now the officer, he got very afraid and he was very tensed. He started thinking that what should I do? If I did not give the summons, if I did not give the written notice to the Sultan, Qazi will not allow me to come inside the court. Qazi will get angry on me. I have to make some plan so that I could go inside the palace and give the notice to the Sultan. So he is thinking and thinking that how he can reach the Sultan. At last, he began to sound the azan, the call for the prayer, loudly just outside the palace. It was not yet time for the prayer. When the Sultan heard the loud, untimely call, he was greatly surprised. He ordered that the man giving the call should be brought before him immediately. So now what idea did the officer use? He started to begin the sound of azan. Azan means he is calling the people for the prayer. When a person gives a azan, it is said that the person is calling all the people to prayer in the masjid because it is time for prayer. But the Sultan told that, Sultan Ghiyasuddin told that, no, it is not time for the prayer now. So who is the one who is reciting the azan? And he was very shocked to hear that because it was not time for the prayer. So how can any person call the people before the prayer time? So he ordered his guards that bring that man in front of me immediately. I want to see that who is that person. His soldiers rushed out of the palace gates, caught the officer and took him to the Sultan with movements. When the officer knelt before the Sultan, he was trembling with fear. So now what did the soldiers do? The soldiers, they ran outside the palace gates and they caught the officer and they told the officer that come inside fast. Our Sultan has called you. Now the officer, he went inside and he knelt before the Sultan. And he was trembling with fear, means he was shaking with fear because he had got very afraid. He was thinking, now what is Sultan going to do with me? But he mustered all his courage and explained why he had given the call for azan. Then with shaking hands, he gave the summons to the Sultan. Sultan Ghiyasuddin took it without making any comment. He read the summons and told the officer to go back to the Qazi. He announced that he would appear in the Qazi's court the next day. Now, Sultan, he asked the officer that why you gave the azan when it was not time for the prayer? What was the reason? So the officer, he got very afraid and with shaking hands, he gave the summons to the Sultan and he said that, Sultan, you had done a mistake. So the Qazi had ordered you to come to the court. So Sultan, without asking any questions or without showing any type of doubts, he took the summons from the officer and he told him that you may go back to the court and tell Qazi that tomorrow I will be in front of him on time. The next morning, the Sultan got ready to appear before the Qazi. He hid a sharp sword in his robe and set out. So the next morning, the Sultan, he got ready because the Qazi had called him to the court. So The Sultan, he got ready because the Qazi had called him to the court. But when he was going out, he hid a small sword in his robe, means in his clothes, and he started to move out. The courtroom was packed with people. Everyone was eager to see what would happen. The Qazi entered and took his place on the high seat of honor. In a little while, Sultan Ghiyasuddin entered the courtroom. Everyone stood up to show respect to the Sultan, but the Qazi did not get up. The Sultan stood in the docks and the trial began. So when the Sultan went to the courtroom was full of people. And when the Sultan entered inside the courtroom, everyone stood up in his honor to show him respect. But the Qazi did not get up. Now why did the Qazi did not get up? Because the Qazi is the head of the court, and Qazi is going to give the decision. He is going to give the judgment. So he is a big person in the court now. That's why he did not stood up to show respect to the Sultan. The widow presented her complaint. The Qazi took note of all the evidence and in a grave voice addressed the Sultan. Now the Sultan was standing in the docks. Docks means, have you seen the court in the movie or in the cartoon? Court means where the person who has done the mistake, he also comes there, and the person who is innocent, he also comes there. Both of them are there. The judge is also there. Judge means the Qazi. Now the Qazi is going to give the judgment. And here the innocent widow, she is giving the complaint against the Sultan. So the old widow, she told that what mistake Sultan has done. So the Qazi wrote it down, and in a very strong grave voice, means in a very strong voice, he said to the Sultan that you are guilty of causing the death of the only son of this poor widow. According to the law, you must pay a fine for this offense. I order you to do that without delay. Now the Sultan is the Qazi is telling that Sultan, you have done a mistake, and your mistake is that you have killed the only son of this poor widow, and here in the court you are a wrong person because you have done a crime, and according to the law, according to the rules, you have to pay a fine for this offense. Now offense means a crime, a wrong thing. So you have done a wrong thing. So without making a delay, means without wasting a time, you have to pay a fine for your mistake. The Sultan accepted the judgment and apologized to the widow. He arranged to pay the fine immediately. The widow felt satisfied that the offense was brought home to the offender. Now the Sultan, he told that I accept my mistake and I am ready to pay the fine. Without wasting any time, he arranged to pay the fine to the old widow. The old widow was very happy because the Sultan is a person who has done wrong. Now offender means the person who has done some wrong thing, or he has done something illegal, means which is not acceptable. An offense means crime. So the old lady is telling that I am very happy because the person who has done a wrong thing, a crime, has been punished. When the case was over, the Qazi got up from his high seat of honor. Respectfully, he bowed to the Sultan and requested him to take his seat. Now the case is over. Now Sultan has accepted his mistake. So now the Qazi got up because now the case is over. Now he is not a judge anymore because the case is done. only for the case time he is the judge and he is getting high honor and high respect. So now the case is over. So the Qazi got up from his seat and he bowed down in respect before the Sultan and he said the Sultan that, Sultan, please take your seat. You can sit down. The Sultan then drew the hidden sword from his robes and told the Qazi, I am happy that you did not waver in your duty. You did not hesitate to punish me. Otherwise, I would have beheaded you with this sword. Now the Sultan is telling that, see Qazi, I have brought a sword with me. If you would have not punished me, I would have really cut off your head from your body. But you did not do this mistake. You punished me. You obeyed the rules. I am happy with you. If you had not punished me, I would have surely cut off your head with my sword. The Qazi then put his hand under the cushion where the Sultan was seated and brought up a whip. He said, Your Majesty, I am happy because you obeyed the law. Otherwise, I would have whipped you in the court. So now Qazi, he just removed one whip under the cushion. He had also hid a whip under his cushion. Cushion means a pillow. The Qazi said that, Sultan, if you would have not accepted your mistake, I was also going to beat you with my whip. But I am happy because you accepted the mistake and you obeyed my judgment. The Sultan then got up and embraced the Qazi. Thank God, we both did our duty, he said. So the Sultan got up and he praised the Qazi. That Qazi, even if I am a king, you did not hesitate. You did not got frightened to punish me. You did your duty well. And the Sultan is also telling, I am also a king, but I also accepted my mistake. Thank God that we both have done our duty well. You also punished me and I also accepted my mistake which I have done. Everyone present in the courtroom praised the two great men. So the people who were in the courtroom, they started praising the Qazi and they started praising the Sultan because both have done their duty in a very good way. So students, what we understood from this lesson, we understood that whether we are a very big personality and if we had done any mistake, we should not show off of our position, but we should accept our mistake and try not to repeat the mistake. And even if I am the person who is going to punish you, I should also not get afraid that you are a king. So how can I punish you? No, this is wrong. If mistake is done by any of the person, we have full rights to punish that person. We should not break the rules for the big personalities of people. Rules are same for everyone, whether it is a common man or whether he is having a big personality. We should have equal rules for everyone. So students, try to understand this lesson and read the lesson. We will meet in the next class with a new topic. Thank you.